Hello student, welcome to standard 9th. We are studying chapter 4th of history, that is economic development part 8. So let us begin the next topic, that is issue of workers. The first textile mill was started in Mumbai on 11th July 1851 by Kawasji Davar. So that was the first mill, textile mill was started in Mumbai. Eventually, mills started in Dadar, Parel, Bhaikala, Shivdi, Prabhadevi and Worli in Mumbai. Therefore, this part came to be known as Girangaon or town of mills. So it was considered as town of mill or the Girangaon. Quite many textile mills were opened up in those particular region. So in the 1980s, the increasing unrest among workers was due to the economic condition in other sections. In some industries, the wages of the workers were increasing. They were also getting more amount of bonus. They were getting more facilities than the textile mill workers. So why these mill workers were unrest? Why they were sad? Was that the other mills which was open, the other industries, the other factories than the textile mill which was opened up at that time, the workers who were working in other industries, in other mills, were getting more salary than the workers who were working in the textile mills. Secondly, they were getting bonus. During the Diwali vacation, they used to get bonus, much more bonus than the textile mill workers. Third, the facilities which was provided in the other industries were much better than the textile industry. The workers were not getting facilities of the textile workers, and therefore there was unrest among the workers. Worst still is was that they were not getting good treatment. So, do you know, Mahatma Jyotiba Phule's associate Narayan Meghaji Lokhande, this Narayan Meghaji Lokhande has made an effort resulted in the weekly Sunday holiday for mill workers from 1st January 1882. So that means that these mill workers were not getting Sunday holidays. They have to work for 30 days. Then only they would get the monthly salary. There were no weekly off was there. So these close associates of Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, Mr. Narayan Meghaji Lokhande, made an effort with British government, and then workers, mill workers especially, started getting the Sunday weekly off. So now the workers were not happy, and therefore there was unrest among them. In the Diwali of 1981, the workers expected to get a bonus of 20% on their salary, a bonus. The Rashtriya Mill Mazdoor Sangh, it is an organization, it is an union which was negotiating with the employers. They agreed, this Rashtriya Mill Mazdoor Sangh agreed upon 8% to 17% of bonus without taking the workers into consideration. So these union leaders they themselves, with the factory owners, they themselves have decided that a worker should get 8 to 17% bonus and not of 20%. Bonus is extra payment besides the salary, which is given annually once a year to every workers. So this extra salary or little more than salary is considered as bonus, is paid to every worker. Okay, so Rashtriya Mil Mazdoor Sangh Union had taken decision that 8 to 17%, that means the bonus amount was cut short, and they did not even ask any employer, anyone. They have taken the decision. So the cut in the bonus proved to be the cause of unrest. This was the main cause of unrest. Why did we get less bonus? Some workers went to Dr. Datta Samant. They asked him to accept their leadership. You be our leader and you do something for us. Workers of 65 mills came together and Dr. Datta Samant led the strike. So they went on strike. They put on locks to the factories. No works. On 18 Jan 1982, 2.5 lakh workers went on a strike. So 2.5 lakh workers means not a small body. It's quite a lot, quite a many workers. And all the factories were closed down. Girangao mills stopped running, making it seems like Mumbai's heart stopped throbbing. Dil dhadakna, Bombay ka dil hi dhadakna band ho gaya. Ye bahut bahut badi baat ho gayi. It's a tremendous loss to Mumbai, to the people, and therefore everything came to an end. It was stopped. Mumbai's heart was stopped. Do you know, the working class had contributed culturally as well through folk theatre, folk art and literature. Anna Bhau Sathe, Shahir Amar Sheikh, Shahir Savale were popular from their programs aimed at public education. Poets like Narayan Surve, Namdev Desal, etc. portrayed the real life of the workers throughout their poem. So this poem, Namdev Desal and Narayan Surve were a really great poet, and workers' life they used to portray exactly how they are going through, how difficult situation they are facing. So such thing these two poets, Namdev Desal and Narayan Surve, used to write through their poems. So 2.5 lakh people went on strike. So what had happened? The Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Barrister E.R. Antule, set up a committee to solve this problem. Naturally, because the heart of Mumbai had stopped throbbing, and therefore to solve somewhere, to come to a conclusion, to negotiate somewhere, they started solving this issue, E.R. Antule. Later, Babasaheb Bhosle became a chief minister of Maharashtra. He insisted that as per law, he would talk only with the Rashtriya Mil Mazdoor Sangh. Dr. Datta Samant demanded that the law be revoked. So, Rashtriya Mil Mazdoor Sangh and Datta Samant, and they wanted to have, according to the law, negotiation. In the beginning, the striking workers received help from their native villages. All the workers who had come from Konkan, who had come from different places, they started getting help from their home, native places. It was also not very difficult for them to help each other. So those who were little well-to-do, they used to help each other. They set up departmental committee and distributed food grains, assistance in the form of funds, etc. So they started giving food grains to each other through this departmental store. The left parties had supported the strike, the leftists. As the strike dragged on, efforts were made to split the striking workers' rank. So again, split and divide policy was used there, and they wanted to stop this somewhere. Even as the strike completed 6 months, the central government completely ignored it, did not pay any attention over there, they didn't take any action. The workers started Jail Bharo agitation, Jail Bharo Andolan. In September 1982, 1.5 lakh workers took a march on the Legislative Assembly of Maharashtra State, Vidhan Sabha. They went marching. It didn't help at all. The strike completed a year. Ek saal pura ho gaya, workers were without work, without payment. They were getting little help from their homes, native places, or some people were helping. Now, who would give them the help constantly? Therefore, the situation became worse. People went on strike, marching on the assembly. It did not help at all. The strike completed a year. This was the first strike to have gone on for a year. In this period, about 1.5 lakh workers became unemployed. So no work, no payment, and then no payment, what to have? How to look after family, how to run the family was the problem. At the same time, as polyester had come into greater demand than cotton cloth, the sale of meal cloth had already got affected. The mills moved from Mumbai to Surat in Gujarat. So what had happened is, at that time, the polyester was just introduced. All these mills in Mumbai were producing cotton clothes. Since the polyester came into the scene, the cotton clothes demand went down. Many people started using polyesters, and therefore this mill cloths which was in demand went down. And therefore all the mill owners thought of shifting their mills from Mumbai to Surat, that is Gujarat. The central government nationalized 13 textile mills. Appointment of arbitrates did not help to resolve the issue. 13 mills were nationalized. 13 mills became under control of government. They become a nation's mill, government's mill. But this did not help the problem, because they were near about 65 mills. Only 13 were nationalized. What about the others? And therefore, many mills went from Mumbai to Surat. So the problem, this issue was a severe issue. Let us see the economic policy. Let us see the new economic policy in the next lecture. Till then, have a nice time. Bye bye.